In this video, I want to talk a little bit about the difference between tool calls in your n8n workflows and using sub workflows. All right, and so you may be familiar kind of with this kind of structure here with the AI agent. It has these tools and you're like, oh yeah, that's a standard agent that everybody is doing on YouTube, right? That's pretty much it. That's what everybody's building is these agents that have tools. And then sometimes you see this workflow over here, and often what they'll do is they'll have an execute. All right, so you have your trigger there. And what you'll do is you'll have some other process, and what'll happen is you'll have this process that then calls this other process. And I've always wondered, like, why did they do that? That, like, even within the same workflow, that just never made sense to me. Why not just add a loop? Like, why did you need to call a workflow? And so I always kind of was wondering, like, does this even make sense? Because I was watching all these YouTubers, right? Does it even make sense to have this sub workflow process node and have other agents doing stuff when I can just set up an AI agent right here to do this, right? Like, why on earth would I bother? And I've come to learn some kind of truths about how this all works. So I want to share that with you today. So tool calls are when you have an AI agent who is using the tool, right? And now I'll often say that most of my bots are tool bots, and most of my bots end up using this, and I'm like, oh, well, I'll call a tool bot. Well, it is a tool because it's still an agent, but in a way, it's just another workflow. And so if you think of it, when you're using really any of these, but more specifically the execute workflow nodes, that is not so much a tool call as just a continuation of the process that your workflow is following. It's as if you're sticking in a whole bunch of other nodes in place of this one here, or in place of this. This is actually just kind of the continuation of this, all right? And this just kind of breaks off and then it goes and does this whole other process that it would be doing over here, all right? Whereas tool calls are different. Tool calls are where your AI agent is given instruction on how to use certain things. Now, it doesn't have to be a workflow, all right? It doesn't have to be that. It can be like a Google Sheets, here we go. We give it a Google Sheet tool, and now the AI agent is able to call Google Sheets, is able to get information from my Google Sheet or my Google Doc or a PDF or pretty much any other tool that you're able to hook up to these AI agents, and it's able to then get the information out, process it how it needs to within the AI agent, and then output its result in the way I want it to. Well, that's obviously the goal, right? And sometimes it doesn't. There are issues with it, especially if you stack too many of these tools up. If you have just too many agents or tools attached to your AI agent there, it's gonna very quickly get confused unless you're using like one of these bleeding edge models like Claude 4. If you're using Claude 4, you can probably stack a whole bunch of these models up. But if I recall, the context window for Claude 4 isn't super, super huge. It's only like 250,000 tokens, whereas something like 4.1 or 4.1 mini has a million token context window. Gemini has like a million token context window. They can handle much bigger systems, but not quite as well as Claude 4. So what's the strengths? What's the weaknesses? Why? What's the difference? What do we care? So what I've come to learn is, when I would use tool calls, I'm going to either be using it, one, because I need my AI agent to make the decision of what information is being pulled. I might not know it. I'm like, and I could probably build out an AI agent that then does some sort of like structured output, that then does a call, that then passes the information and all that. But like, that's a bunch of extra work. Why not just have the AI agent do it itself? I can just attach the tool to it, have it decide what information needs to be pulled. It pulls the information or does the search, or, you know, because I can hook up an HTTP node here, hook that up to Google search. Now I have a search bot. My AI agent is fully capable of doing research. And then I can include in the system prompt how to output the information the way I want it to. All right, I can ask it to just give me raw data. I can ask it to process it. Whereas if I just had a, here, I think I have an actual example. If I have something like this that's pulling just straight from a blog, it's pulling straight from a website, the information that I'm getting is all of the HTML code from that site, and it's so much text, and it's not going to be processed by an AI. And I sometimes wonder, like, well, if I just hooked up that node here and attached it to the AI, how on earth is the AI getting the information? Like, it boggled my mind. And it's because the AI is actually not getting all of that information. It's doing the call to the website, and then it's extracting out only the information it needs, and so it's limiting the amount of tokens. Whereas a system like this over here, it's getting all that information. I have to use a code node in order to strip out all the HTML to be able to feed it to an AI agent first, in order for the AI agent to even be able to process it, because otherwise it's just too much data. So tool calls allow the AI agent to get just what it needs when it's using the calls. It's able to figure out what it needs when it does the call in the first place, and it's able to use multiple tools in one shot. Now, this feature is a little iffy depending on what you're doing. You need to make sure you have the right system prompt for it. Otherwise, it's not going to do it. But you can have a system that's able to call a Google Sheet, get the information out at once, and then maybe call a calculator to be able to do the calculation on whatever numbers to then output your result. All right, you can stack up the tools to be able to create something more powerful in this way. Now, the other method is using subworkflows. Now, subworkflows are really for when you have big, complex processes that you know exactly what information is going to come in every single time, or at least, at the very least, how it's going to be structured. All right, so I don't think I have my my full bot open. No, I don't. So I don't have it open at the moment, but my Roger framework, it has all of these different tool calls, but they all are doing this. It's not AI agents doing it. And the reason for it is I wanted to send everything through a process. I didn't want to have an AI agent try to do something and then it come back to this one bot and then continue that process. I wanted to just go to that other process and let that process finish out. Okay? So what is happening is the sub workflow allows me to have very, very specific clarity on what's going to happen with my data. Right? Again, with the AI agent, it's going to make a decision of what information is going to be passed. It makes the call to the tool. And that tool, again, could be an entire workflow, but it's going to decide what information is going to go in and how it's going to be processed. And then it's going to sit there and it's going to wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait until the process is done. Well, if you have process upon process upon process, that AI agent is just going to sit there, and there's a chance that it might time out. There's a chance that it might get data back that isn't quite what you needed it to be in order to be processed further. Instead, what you can use is you can use a sub workflow and then have an entire process. So here, here's my Instagram posting bot. All right, and so it's being called with a sub workflow. My main orchestrator agent is calling this one using a sub workflow, and then it's gonna end the process. At the end, it just ends. Every single one of these just ends. It's not going back to my agent because there's no need to, because it's all self-contained within this. I'm just gonna pass the information I need to. I don't have to worry about structuring a response that needs to be very specific to go back to my AI agent. If I was using kind of this structuring here, in order for it to, not that one, this one, I don't need to have that kind of specific response that goes back to the agent that's then going to just go, okay, task complete, when I can just have it finish out in the workflow. And so you would want to use an execute workflow node when you intend to just be done with the call in the workflow. Whereas if you're using a tool call, you want it to continue on the process. You want it to keep going and maybe do something else with it. I mean, otherwise it's going to come back and your AI agent's going to be, it can respond to you. You can like stick a Slack trigger here or a Telegram trigger, and it's going to be able to say, hey, task complete. But again, there's the possibility that you overload it. It's extra tokens that you might need to use when you could have just passed a little bit of data here and you didn't need the AI agent. The AI agent's, you know, costing you some tokens. Now, again, it's, you know, almost negligible anymore because of the pricing, but it also depends on the model that you're using. Like here, I'm using what, 4.1 mini. If you needed, you know, Claude 4, that's expensive. If you need it to be able to run multiple different tools, that's expensive. Whereas I could have cut out the middleman can cut this out. Just do bop, bop like that. Cut that out. Run it over here. And now I'm just calling another workflow just automatically and using maybe a less expensive model. And then I might hook up another execute workflow, and then to be able to run a second process. And then I can run it through another execute workflow to run another process and another process. And that's essentially the same as having this agent here doing the tool call, except I don't need the agent in the middle because I just need to make sure that my data is being passed in the right way to the next bot. All right, so agents and tool calls are really for when the agent needs to make the decision of what information needs to be put in, okay? Think in terms of actually pure, true agents, the ones that are making decisions, whereas sub workflows are for automations, right? There's a difference between agents and automations. Those automations are just processes that go and go forward. Now, you may have AI bots inside of it, LLMs making decisions and all of that, but it's the one continuous flow. Whereas agents might not even use that tool that time. They might use different tools. They can do different things. It allows you to have a little bit more freedom, but the outcome isn't always as certain. Whereas with the sub workflows, your process is going to be the same every time, and you can expect pretty much the same result every time. Okay, hopefully that was helpful. If it was, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. It really does help get this information out there to those who need it. Also, if you want a bunch of free n8n workflows and a ton of extra tutorials, join my free school community. I got a ton of stuff from social media posting bots to executive assistants to lead scrapers and so much more, all available absolutely for free. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.